I be talking to myself, like, in the mirror and shit, like, is you ready for this shit? Are you? What's up? I wasn't ready for that 100 mil, but now I am. Rumor been ready for war, then the gun jam. I guess God wasn't ready for him. Hey, you blessed. He wasn't ready for you, homie. I was born ready, day one. Since a child I was groomed, I'm just me. And I ain't got no respect for a goon. Why not? Career killers killed by who they love. Bricks and 94 in a split. You my plug, respect it. How many you really know Mexicans? None of the Draco in the crowd, pedestrian. And look at you, ain't really killers. Catch your body, tip to get you. You crying all in your feelings. Damn. You with double chin, kill him, kill him. Making them type of statements.
Why you do that?
Damn, you just on the gram. Exaggeration, but squad dead and mob what? This. How you pull up and rob shit? Facts is you ain't ready, then you a whole bitch. I survived, I sent some cold shit.
I really did.
No longer speak to my partner, cause he did whole shit. No longer with my bitch. Situation petty. I could've patched it, fished it up, but I really wasn't ready. You think you ready for prison? You think you can stop the day, go do a 20-year sentence, huh? And keep my name out your mentions.
Coming up next, it's a UFC Women's Bantamweight Division matchup. Well, if she is not the best ground-and-pound fighter in the women's game today, give me another name, right? Because she has taken it to the next level, and more often than not, when she gets you down and starts throwing punches, referee's coming in shortly thereafter.
The referee jumping in to save her opponents has almost become...
Yeah, synonymous with her fights.
It's the way that her fights end. She's beating him so badly that the ref has to jump in and save them. We have not seen anyone so good at ground-and-pound since Tatiana Suarez first entered the UFC, and she has taken that to a whole nother level. Her ability to just control posture, control range, and land from anywhere from the top position is truly inspiring to watch.
And not unlike you, she's got a mean streak. She told us in the fighter meeting on Thursday, I'm about to give her some scars for life. So free souvenirs coming on the ground if we get there tonight. Well, drillers make killers, and nobody works her takedowns harder than this young woman. She has become a force in this division, and even though the opposition oftentimes knows what's coming, no one's able to stop that shot.
Nobody's able to stop that takedown attempt. No one's able to stop that single leg. She said in the fighter meeting, I have thrown that takedown 5,000 times.
Amazing.
Over and over, I hit a single leg. Every day of the week, I hit at least 30 single legs. I'm like, well, is wrestling practice every day? She goes, no. I just want to make sure that I have a skill that is so dominant that no matter how much you practice it, you are not practicing it enough to stop me from taking you down with it. It is truly crazy to watch her approach to getting that single leg off.
And her ability to get her opponents off balance in a mixed martial arts setting, as special as anybody in the sport right now. We'll see how it goes for her here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. Live from the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, and now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a mixed martial artist making her professional debut here tonight. She stands 5'3" tall, weighing in at 112 pounds. Fighting out of Queens, New York, Moore.
All right, mentally rules in the locker room. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. Want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out there.
You ready? You ready?
Well, how good is this? Reminds me of the good old days of Pride, the UFC Grand Prix single night tournament. This has been highly anticipated by fight fans around the world. And remember, if you sustain damage, that could affect you later on in this one night tournament. Good series of strikes by her there. She is staying wicked busy tonight.
Very busy, but also super accurate. She is on point.
Well, you have, and there it is. So her best entry, I think, in terms of the offensive wrestling and takedown attempts, finally gets her opponent down for the first time tonight.
It feels like she gave up on getting the takedown, so it started to flow more naturally.
Right.
She was not forcing her entries anymore. Just let it come to her and not take down to be cool.
Elbow now blocked by Carla Esparza.
Watch knees to the body.
Gets the elbow up into the target.
Nice punch lands over the top. Nice body kick.
Pretty good uppercut by her there. Not a concussive blow per se, but on the other side, you don't want to take
it. Beautiful takedown just landed.
Back to the elbow now. That one's true. Both fighters get up now.
Oh, nice right hand. Lynch. Nice punch there.
Hard shots landing on both sides here. All right, so a takedown attempt by her here, DC, but she's unable to get the fight to her.
She was not able to secure the takedown, but she has to disguise it a little bit better if she's going to take down a fighter as well versed as her opponent.
Stuffs the takedown shot there. How good is her takedown, D? Beautiful straight punch there by Esparza. Nice job by her there to land yet another takedown. I got to think if Gilroy High School Wrestling practice next week, they're going to be watching this film.
I mean, we will show it. I will pull out the projector.
So Esparza is looking for that arm triangle. Back up again. Well, she connects with a right hand. She loves that right hand, and why not?
It's her best punch, and if her opponent doesn't change something, she's gonna go to sleep.
And she connects with a punch there. We'll see if she can follow.
It's the same story, just told on a different day. Takedown after takedown after takedown.
Oh, she's got a good left hand and put it to good use there, DC.
She's very accurate with that strike.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
I love the grappling. It can really be entertaining.
All right, what a round it was for her, largely courtesy of those elbow strikes that seemed to find the target almost every time she threw one.
That is such a dangerous strike. One elbow can really give you a cut that will damage your entire approach to the fight. If her opponent does not find space, or she does not start seeing these elbows as they are coming, her night is going to end very quickly.
All right, round one just okay. Round two is now upon us. How did you approach the first round in the fight compared to other rounds? I know it's a tough question for a heavyweight.
Round number one is usually the round where you gotta make sure you aren't putting yourself in any danger. We saw that for both of these young women. We saw that they were both a little bit tentative, but right now expecting action to really pick up. Oh! Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Just out of range with that right hand. All right, so she does it again as she gets another takedown. Her opponent's done a decent job getting back to her feet, but once again gets planted firmly on her back here.
She needs to defend earlier because the moment this young lady gets her hands locked around your legs, locked around your body, she has so many different takedown attempts, so many different finishes, so many different skills, it's hard to keep up with her. She has to defend earlier, a lot earlier.
And there's a takedown attempt.
Great punch. Big body kick.
Again, she chooses to clinch here. Well, she's landed.
What a beautiful takedown.
Esparza gets the single leg takedown. Nicely done there. Man, she is just nonstop on the ground. Esparza's looking for that arm triangle now.
Watch triangle.
Oh, nice job.
Oh, man, that was slick.
Making all these shots count. Oh, well played there as she gets back to her feet.
That was nice. Right.
They continue to exchange.
Oh, big head kick.
Oh, the right hand is there for her. She's starting to put together some significant body work here, and these are going to take their toll as this fight goes up.
Shot a double leg.
Oh, massive slam. That'll change the complexion of this one. Both fighters back to their feet now.
Big kick lands.
So Esparza's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling.
Beautiful body kick.
And they separate.
Right hand punch in the clinch.
Takedown attempt late in the round, and she gets it. Great movement by her here on the ground, and she just does it so fluidly and so easily. It's really a sight to behold.
You can tell that she's been a lifetime developing the skill with the way that she's able to move with so little effort on the mat.
All right, so we will see another round here. Sat her opponent down there in that previous round with a punch.
Surprisingly, we are going forward because I thought it was over. I saw that punch land. We started to yell. We started to scream. We thought the fight was done, but we move forward because her opponent is so tough, but she's so skilled that she can get there again.
Watch that last round, another pretty good frame for both fighters. We'll see which woman makes the requisite adjustments here in this next round.
Somebody has to really get out ahead. It's too worrisome going to the judges when you know you've been involved in such a competitive fight. Oh, big elbow. Oh,
vicious combo there.
Clinching.
All right, so she lands another takedown here. I'm not saying she could take you down, but she's had no problem taking her opponent down tonight and continues to score points even though she's not necessarily keeping her down.
She's doing it over and over again, and she's so confident in her wrestling that even though you may not think she can take me down, John, she in her mind definitely believes it. Beautiful punch. Beautiful body kick lands right under the elbow.
Oh, she blocks the punch. Whoa!
You can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
So Esparza's looking for that arm triangle.
Watch triangle.
Nicely done. Oh, sage work from the bottom here as she tags her with the punch. Wow, is she applying a lot of pressure here. I'm not sure how much her opponent can take. Clear sense of urgency here as she tries to make sure the judges stay out. Oh!
She is such a diverse fighter.
That'll do it!
What a performance!
That was a good stoppage by the referee. She was not effectively defending herself, and the opponent was doing some real damage. It became a dangerous situation. I think it's the right call by the official, and she will live to fight another day. All right, we take a look back at some of the pictures from this one, and she had it all going on tonight, but certainly her boxing was on point.
Her boxing always is what allows her to dictate the pace of fights. Finally, she landed the strike that ended the night of her opponent.
All right, let's go inside the octagon where Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta calls a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 59 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by knockout.
Well, you see the raw emotions and the happiness out of her in her corner. What a result here tonight as she gets it done by knockout.
I mean, she could not have imagined that it would go this well. I know she said it would happen, but when it does, I mean, it's joy. It's joy like nothing you've ever felt before. You don't expect it.
All right, coming up next, it's a UFC bantamweight division matchup. Jab placement there, and a nice job to take advantage of her edge and reach.
Liver kick. If you take those kicks, it's going to shut your body off. Ooh, what a punch. You don't know when that leg kicks up.
Oh, spinning back fist. Didn't see that one coming. Uppercut to the head. Instead, it's blocked by Jean. She missed with that jab. Spinning back fist for her out of nowhere. Man, her striking looks clean tonight. Timing on point.
Her timing's on point. Her accuracy's on point.
Oh! Knocked out by the spinning back fist.
Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Wade Lee going with the kick to the body, but unable to find the range. She lands a kick there. She might be the best kicker in this division.
She may just be the best kicker.
And really nice job to finish the takedown there. Well, she was long on grappling experience coming into the UFC, and you see her chops here, just beautiful when it comes to the transition game.
It's very difficult to keep up with her on the ground.
Back to the feet now.
What a punch.
Some nice back and forth action here. Just over 2 minutes to go in what has been a furious round one.
Right hand punch in the clinch.
Zhang's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling.
Big kick.
Stoppage by the referee. She was not effectively defending herself, and the opponent was doing some real damage. It became a dangerous situation. I think it's the right call by the official, and she will live to fight another day. The official decision is inside the octagon. That's where we find Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 41 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Russo.
Well, there she is. This arena belongs to her here tonight. Hard-pressed to find a knockout in the women's.
For certain, and my body on fire. like they be like, who's just searching? Turns out I'm never in a drought. From what these said,
coming up next, it's a UFC Women's Bantamweight Division matchup.
You ready? You ready?
Well, no better way to pay homage to the history of pride in the UFC with this single night UFC Grand Prix tournament. Some of the best fighters in the world have come out. Let's see who will be the last fighter standing here tonight. All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming.
Circling towards the left side now.
Nice body kick right under the elbow. Ooh, what a punch.
Oh, big elbow. Massive right hand. Oh! Oh, straight right.
Nice kick.
Oh, nice job by her there to split the guard and land her straight punch.
That punch is so straight and it's so fast. She's having a difficult time picking up the timing of her opponent's strike.
Oh, beautiful hook.
Big punch lands through the middle.
Oh, nasty cut there right on the bridge of the nose. And both fighters exchange in the pocket. Well, she's been good tonight, but she missed with that one. Ooh. Under 2 minutes to go in a back-and-forth first round here. Oh, man, I'm no strike counter, but that head kick absolutely landed.
That kick got from the floor to her opponent's head before her opponent could react. Big punch land.
Under a minute now to go on the round. Good ground and pound by her here. She felt like she could finish the fight with her ground strikes tonight and might be well on her way here.
I mean, John, I believe it after watching the ground and pound that she's landing in this part of the fight.
Oh!
Oh, straight right! Hit by that kick to the body. All right, now we check out some of the action from that previous round, DC. How about the display of striking?
Just high level. I mean, you would think that we're watching a K-1 level kickboxing match opposed to being in the UFC. Both displayed great technical skills, unbelievable striking.
All right, so round two is underway here. Both women had their moments in that first round. At times, it looked like they were feeling each other out. And there is a lot of mutual respect here, though. So maybe you thought the crowd got a little bit restless at times. Ultimately, these fighters are both elite. A lot of respect on both sides. We'll see if they get after it here to begin round two.
Great timing on that beautiful takedown.
Oh, nice job by her to posture up there. Now we'll see if she can maintain that separation.
She has to recognize that her opponent will start trying to squirrel away now, but look for her big ground and pound.
All right, so she's able to work her way back to her feet now.
Ooh, nice right hand. It's such a fast leg kick.
And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands. jab there. Nicely done by Pena. Well, you hate to be overly critical because she has landed some good shots, but really nothing in terms of combinations tonight.
She's got to let it fly, man. She needs to let the combinations fly. She's got to find the confidence knowing that all that repetition, all that work with her boxing coach is going to pay dividends inside of the octagon. What a body kick.
Great vision, great defensive instincts by her there as she continues to block the majority of these shots coming.
Her hands are always where they're supposed to be.
Both fighters throwing heat now.
Real sneaky body kick. Nice entry into the finish for Rekha.
Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement on the ground.
She looks like a master of grappling with the great movement that she's showing on the ground.
And she misses with the left punch there. Well, she has certainly picked up the pace here in round two and starting to find herself in the pocket a little bit. She was a little bit hesitant in round one. No hesitancy whatsoever here in round two. She has clearly found her rhythm and range. Oh, man, that looked like it hurt. Nice kick by her there.
It absolutely did hurt. I can tell you that as a fact.
Ah, she's unable to connect with the left hook.
You got to check these low leg kicks. Good punch, Lance.
Man, that cut just continues to get worse for her.
Real nice body kick, Lance.
Oh, that right hand is on point. Round two next. All right, a lot of tremendous striking action in that last round, DC. I know you don't have a telestrator, but take us through the replay. All right, so the previous two rounds, pretty entertaining, DC. We'll see who has the upper hand here as this next round gets in.
Very evenly matched fight. We knew exactly this when they were matched up. We were excited about the fight. Oh!
Oh, very nice leg kick there. High-level stuff. Well, she has really shored some things up defensively here as she blocks another set of shots there.
She said it was going to be a focus, get better defensively, and tonight.
Oh!
She is such a diverse striker that that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish.
White goes in and secures the takedown. Well, as usual, suffocating work from the top here by Pena. Well, you got to stay busy from the bottom position. Can't falter here. She's doing a nice job. Oh, she's looking to set up that head kick. No good.
Nice looping punch.
Oh, she just continues to land a high volume of strikes here, really just like she did in the previous round, and she does not seem to be slowing down at all. Does she have a soccer background? How about the kick there?
I mean, she must have a soccer background. Oh! Who kicks it? Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Oh! Back and forth we go here. Kenya's overhand punch to the head. It doesn't get there. It was telegraphed and it was blocked.
Great punch landing with so much power.
Well, this is exactly the same.
Wow!
Stoppage by referee. She was not effectively defending herself, and the opponent was doing some real damage. It became a dangerous situation. I think it's the right call by the official, and she will live to fight another day. Let's go inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Lugliotta has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 44 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by knockout, Juliana, the Venezuelan Vixen Peña.
Well, there she is, and you can be sure there's going to be a long line at the after party tonight. All right, coming up next, it's a UFC Women's Bantamweight Division matchup. First-round fighters in UFC history, the former UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion, Ronda Rousey, 9 career wins by armbar. 8 of those have come in round number 1. So you can expect Rousey to go to that patented takedown early. We'll see if she can get yet another dominant submission tonight. Well, she landed a flush knee right there, DC, making great use of her size advantage in this one. Well, you saw us reference that reach advantage off the top, and she certainly made good use of it there in landing that punch. Well, clearly she wanted to get this fight to the ground to try to fatigue the striker early. Mission accomplished so far.
Mission accomplished. Even her team couldn't have imagined that it would work so early in the fight. Great timing on that takedown.
Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up. Timing her shots nicely here tonight, DC.
She's doing a great job, but not only being active, she is so accurate. She's on point tonight.
Oh, nice punch there by Rousey. Whoa!
Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
She moves right into half guard.
Without much effort, she was able to pass from her full guard right into half guard. Nice leg.
And now they are throwing both sides with conviction. Nice job by her there to block those shots. When you first go to a boxing class, the first thing they say is glue your guard to your face. Her guard's high tonight.
Her guard's high, and she keeps the elbow down. She does a great job of blocking the top and down there. Oh, John, that was so nice. What a beautiful takedown.
All right, stacked guard for her now. What would you tell the top fighter here in terms of trying to avoid the escape?
Well, you got to start attacking the feet now. Now you got to start shoving those feet towards the ground, pass them through the middle, or just grab them and pull them up. If you pull them up, right, you don't want the bottom fighter to get the legs extended into you because then it pushes you away. But if you can grab the feet and you pull them up, now you just lead with your knee to take side control. Big kick land.
Overhand block there by Ronda Rousey.
Nice leg kick land. Oh, nice right hand. Nice punch lands over the top.
Oh, perfect head kick there. Oh! Clean with the right hook. What a round. All right, so we now look back at some of the action from that previous round, DC. A lot of good highlights on both sides.
I mean, a lot of good highlights from both competitors. They both should be very proud of what they accomplished. But I'm telling you, man, I'm not sure they can keep this up. If they land at this clip for another 5 minutes, somebody's going to sleep.
You ready to fight? Ready? Go!
Ooh, big shot land. Big leg kick land.
All right, she's landed some pretty good shots here tonight, but still DC unable to string any solid combinations together.
I just don't believe she's confident in being in there. She's very aware of her opponent's power, so it's making her limit her activity on the inside. Throw that out the window. You're the faster fighter. You're successful. Let those combinations string together. Dig and kick.
And they separate. Well, she keeps going back to that right hand. This one's not there for her.
Oh! You can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
Oh, really using her reach advantage to land the jab there, DC.
She is such a diverse. Can't take victory now. She has to be. She has to chase the feet.
Back to the feet. Oh, debilitating knee lands yet again. I've been short my whole life, DC. I'm envious right now seeing this taller fighter realize so much success as she lands another knee. Well, she was a little bit hesitant in round.
Whoa! You can never know what you're gonna see with this young lady. Is she gonna finish the fight?
Well, she's able to get up, but she is officially on wobbly legs. Oh!
She is such a diverse striker that that big strike landed, and it looks like she's gonna finish this fight. That's how you finish a fight.
And again, she slips off the center.
I think she hurt.
Back to her feet now. Good sign for her there.
Look at the angle of that nice body kick.
Well, you know about the offense, but... Whoa! And just like that, the fight is over.
Wow! Oh, my goodness, what a fight.
Most fighters in this division get knocked out by that strike. Near perfect execution. She found a little crack in the defense and found a home for that strike. Landed flush. And that is another one for the highlight reel, but few prettier than that one as she gets the big knockout win here tonight. All right, we take a look back at some of the pictures from this one, and she had it all going on tonight, but certainly her boxing was on point.
Her boxing always is what allows her to dictate the pace of fights. Finally, she landed the strike that ended the night of her opponent.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 13 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by knockout, Rowdy Ronda Rousey!
Well, you see the raw emotions and the happiness out of her in her corner. Coming up next, it's a UFC Women's Bantamweight Division matchup.
You ready? You ready?
All right, so here we go with round one of this highly anticipated affair. Well-rounded, doesn't even begin to describe it. Both women have every skill in the game.
Both of them have every skill in the book. They're so talented. They train so hard. They come from great camps. This is a very even matchup.
DC, for my money, she's really timing her shots pretty well here tonight.
Her timing, accuracy, and also the activity level is great tonight.
Oh, strong punch there by Hall. And just misses with that big right hand.
Big leg kick lands.
Oh, big damaging knees here to the body. Man.
Big body kick lands.
Hall's head kick is blocked, so no damage inflicted there.
Real quick leg kick.
Forward, forward. Wow, huge head kick. Oh, beautifully placed and timed kick there by Hall. Oh, and there's another nice kick. Solid kicks across the board from her tonight.
I mean, she throws the kick without any windup. There's no tell to when she's coming.
And she connects with a punch there, champ.
She's so accurate. She's so good at timing all of her strikes. Chasing the finish, she doesn't get excited and lose the position. That punch to the body does a lot of damage.
Very nice leg kick there by Holm.
Oh, that's a nice strike.
Oh!
You can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
Big knee to the body. Just missing on the high kick there.
You take more of these leg kicks, you will not be able to be very active on your feet.
Oh, nice jab by Holm.
Wow! She is such a diverse striker that that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish this fight.
Oh! And just like that, the fight is over.
It's over. It's over.
If you're trying to send a message to the rest of this division, that is how you send it. So a near-perfect shot for her to end the fight. She had this crowd behind her all night long, and I'm not sure how many other fighters in this division could have absorbed that strike and stayed in the fight. A near-perfect land to get the knockout win here tonight. And there she is after the massive knockout. That is one they will be talking about for quite some time. We now go inside the octagon where Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Stop for this contest at 4 minutes, 19 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Hall.
Well, there she is. This arena belongs to her here tonight. Hard-pressed to find a knockout in the women's game. Coming up next, it's a UFC Women's Bantamweight Division matchup.
You ready?
Reminds me of the good old days of Pride, the UFC Grand Prix single night tournament. This has been highly anticipated by fight fans around the world. And remember, if you sustain damage, that could affect you later on in this one night tournament. Trying to land the elbow there to no avail. Well, she said she was going to go to the takedown early, and she goes right to it, and it's there. So a good sign that she's able to get this fight to the ground where she wants.
She said when and where she decides she was going to be able to secure takedowns. She does exactly that very early in the first round. I mean, look at the commitment to kicking in this fight. Oh, nice.
Oh, big left hook there. Just out of range with that right hook. Whoa!
Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Now goes in and secures the takedown. How good is her movement here on the ground, right? Shades of Ray Borg just transitioning so beautiful.
Yeah, she's so good at transition with movement. Her ability is unmatched.
Shevchenko gets back up. Good sign for her there.
Good mark.
She blocked the punch.
Nice. Oh!
Just over 2 minutes to go in what has been a furious round one.
Oh, that was a really nice takedown.
That's a beautiful escape and reversal by her there.
Unbelievable sweep. She did a fantastic job of manipulating the weight to change the position.
Shevchenko gets back up again. Oh, and she connects there. Beautiful punch.
Great punch, but what's next? What is she going to use to follow it up? Oh, you can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
Oh, beautiful level change.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch and mix. Shevchenko's looking for that arm triangle now. Busy here off of her back. Nice offense from the bottom.
There's no tell on that leg kick.
Whoa!
Oh! Oh!
What an end to round one.
You're killing this girl. She can't hang with you. I need you to stay focused and keep pushing. This fight's...
All right, let us now check out some of the action from that round, DC, and what a display of striking for her.
Yeah, she did a fantastic job of finding her spot, putting herself in position where she was the one landing, and really dictating the pace of the fight. She did a great job of mixing up everything to get in control.
You ready? You ready?
Round two underway.
That's a big strike right there.
Well, that knee strike attempt blocked by Valentina Shevchenko. Nice combination there by Shevchenko. Punctuates it with the kick. And if you're going to stand and trade with Shevchenko, at defense.
Yeah, but that's usually what she does. She's very good at mixing it up and leaving you with a kick at the end. I think back to her fight with Holly Holm. I thought that was one of her greatest performances to date, when she was landing those beautiful combinations and really dictating to Holly how the fight played out.
That's what we call shin on skull. Several times in this fight, she's gone back to the well with that hit.
She is landing it over and over again, so why would she abandon it? It is such a dominant technical skill that every time she throws it, it lands. She's a great combination striker, and she sets up that high kick.
Whoa!
She is such a diverse striker that big strike lands. Oh!
She lands a massive knee to the head.
Big kick lands.
Oh!
Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Big elbow! All right, she postures up here, DC. We'll see if she can get those ground strikes.
Watch for the huge elbows that she's known for.
Shevchenko's looking for that arm triangle.
Watch triangle, watch triangle.
Well, that's a job by her there to reverse the position on the ground.
She was in trouble. Now she is the one handing out the punishment. Great change of position very quickly.
Oh, she's really starting to put together some significant body shots here, attacking both sides now. Whoa!
You can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
Now goes in and secures the takedown. Her ground and pound is downright scary. In constant pursuit of the finish, might get it here.
She does a really good job of throwing punches with intent. She never just throws just to be thrown. Every punch is meant to land, and every punch is meant to start a finish.
All right, 20 seconds to go in the round.
Powerful leg kick lands.
For her there as she makes her way back to the stool. There was the knockdown there in the middle of the round, DC. Talk us through it.
She did a great job of really finding her spot, really recognizing an opportunity, really getting to exactly where she needed to be to finish the fight. But don't think that this young lady will rush. She'll take her time, hopefully get there again to end the night.
And she lands a punch there. We'll see if she can start to turn these singular strikes into combinations now.
She's going to have to find something to follow that big strike that she's landing over and over again.
Oh, continuing to work the body to great effect. Oh, that is a nice
jab. She is such a diverse striker that that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish this fight.
Nice job by her there. You see how strong she is. Her opponent's trying to control posture, unable to do so.
Now she can get to work and put the money in the bank with that grounded pound.
Money in the bank.
Can't take many of those. You better check.
Oh, you can see her limp it a little bit now. That leg is hurting for certain. Well, how urgent is this fighter down the stretch? She is really lighting her up now. She found her range in the middle of this fight, and she is making up for lost time. Well, she's been good tonight, but she missed without.
Ooh, big shot to the body.
78 total strikes have now landed for Valentina Shevchenko. And above 50% too when it comes to the connection rate, landing with 51% accuracy against Valentina Shevchenko. All right, so she goes to the kick and promptly lands. Nicely done there.
She has done that over and over again. Every time she throws it, it's landed. Big head kick lands.
All right, so the fighter's in the clinch again, DC. I get tired just watching these situations.
It's exhausting. This is a position where you are constantly draining at the gas tank of your opponent.
Whoa!
You can never know what you're going to see. But this young lady, is she going to finish the fight?
Big elbow there. Man, she is just nonstop on the ground, moving in all the right directions. Another nice transition by her there.
She's moving a lot, and every movement has purpose.
All right, so will the elbows and knees soon follow? The first step is the tie clinch. She has it here.
She secured the tie clinch. Now she's going to start the elbow and knee to try to put damage on her opponent.
Oh, nice shot to get the takedown late in the round. Certainly not resting on her laurels here as we wind it down in this round.
She's a grinder. She's going to take it out at the beginning of the round, middle, and the end. You have to know that you will be constantly under attack from this wrestle-heavy approach.
All right, so there's the end of the round. She didn't force the finish after getting that knockdown with the head kick, but was very close to getting the job done there for good in that round.
She's so patient. She's never going to overextend herself. She's never going to rush. She's never going to force anything. She will always stay exactly in her pocket. She will stay exactly in her rhythm. She believes that eventually the finish will come.
You ready?
All right, here is round four. Fight scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds. Oh, she continues to land a high number of strikes here, just like she did in the previous round. Shevchenko gets the takedown. Goes upstairs for an elbow. Shevchenko's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Connects with a right.
Big kick lands.
Oh, she blocked the kick there. Nicely done. Ooh! Well done. Whoa!
She is such a diverse striker.
Wow. Wow.
Wow! Wow!
That was a good stoppage by the referee. She was not effectively defending herself, and the opponent was doing some real damage. It became a dangerous situation. I think it's the right call by the official, and she will live to fight another day. Let's go inside the octagon now to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 35 seconds of round number four. Declaring the winner by knockout, Bulldog.
Well, there she is, and you can be sure there's going to be a long line at the after party tonight. It's a UFC women's bantamweight division matchup.
You ready?
Well, no better way to pay homage to the history of pride in the UFC with this single night UFC Grand Prix Tournament. Some of the best fighters in the world have come out. Let's see who will be the last fighter standing here tonight.
Look at the force behind that leg kick.
And that one was heavy.
Nice.
Oh, how good was that right hand? Beautiful connection by her there.
Right down the pipe, right on the chin. Oh, nice jab.
Well, she lands the punch there. You know, it's one thing to have an edge in reach. It's another thing to take advantage. Nicely done by her there.
Good stick.
Now a knee to the body.
Oh,
she nailed the double leg takedown there. Oh, nice job by her to posture up there. Now we'll see if she can maintain that separation.
She has to recognize that her opponent will start trying to squirrel away now, but look for her big grounded pound.
And they separate.
Nice job of hiding that head kick.
Got clipped with the right hand.
Nice straight punch.
Well, she continues to leave that head open, and she paid for it there. She's almost moving into the strike. She hasn't changed up her tempo, and she continues to keep her head on that center line. We'll see if she can make the proper adjustments here.
Beautiful kick.
Throws the right hand there. Oh, she's got the right hand going tonight, DC.
She's in a great flow, and she's throwing from her dominant side to land that great strike. Straight punch lands.
Oh!
Can't take pictures now. She can never know what you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight? Oh, nice high kick. Nice kick.
Oh, she connected with that right hand, DC.
She's so fast when she throws it, there is no tell as to when that right hand is coming.
20 seconds to go.
Beautiful strike. Oh, nice.
I'm not sure her striking has ever looked better, DC. Finding the range with relative ease here tonight.
She's doing a great job of timing everything. She is seeing everything out there.
All right, so there's the horn. The round is over, and we've got more fighting. It looked like maybe we'd get a finish there after she landed upstairs.
Well, she was excited. She thought it was done. How does she reshift? How does she go back in the moment to try to repeat what she just did, but also top it and actually get the finish?
You ready? You ready?
All right, let's get to round two. Oh, pinpoint execution on that straight punch. She's got a reach advantage, and it was pretty obvious in that sequence there. Throws a big right hand, but doesn't find its home.
You can really limit the mobility of your opponent with those leg kicks.
Oh! Huge right hand!
She is such a diverse striker that that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish this fight.
Oh! Just missed with the left there.
Punch over the top.
Oh!
Can't take pictures now.
Whoa! Oh, the ground is pounding his own point here. She's made this a focus going in to make these strikes count. Certainly doing that tonight.
She's making each and every one of them count. Very, very good job of landing shots, slamming them in combination, and making them all matter.
Well, she has certainly...
Oh. What you're going to see with this young lady. Is she going to finish the fight?
Great movement by her here on the ground, and she just does it so fluidly and so easily. It's really a sight to behold.
You can tell that...
That'll do it! That's it!
Oh, my goodness! What a performance!
That'll get the crowd on its feet. A near-perfect land to end the fight for her here tonight. Just the way she drew it up, she had her focus on the knockout, and that's exactly the way this fight ends. I'm not even sure the opponent saw the shot coming. They oftentimes say it's the shot you don't see coming that spells your fate, and that certainly spelled her fate here tonight. The official decision is in. It resides with Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 46 seconds of round number 2. Declare the winner by knockout, Viviana V.P. Araujo.
Well, you see the... Coming up next, it's a UFC Women's Bantamweight Division matchup.
You ready? You ready?
All right, so here we go with round one. We're expecting a lot of action and really to see both women challenged in all phases of mixed martial arts.
They're both so talented. They're both so good at every aspect of fighting. I want to see who can truly force their style on the other one.
Nice punch there by Nunes. Oh, she didn't telegraph that one at all. Spinning back fist. Whoa!
She is such a diverse striker that that big...
She is after the huge knockout here tonight. What a moment for this fighter. You can't help but feel good for her here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 1:03 of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Lauren.
Oh, there she is. This arena belongs to her here tonight. Hard-pressed to find a knockout in the women's game, as stunning as that.
I mean, she has so much confidence in her hand that she's willing to stand in front of her opponent and take one to give one. And when she gave one, it shut the opponent's lights out. Great job finding that kill shot.